About a month ago, I dropped this video appearing on your screen right now about how I made over $63,000 in 63 days selling digital products as a beginner. Since then, about 40 to 45 days later, I've almost doubled that amount and I've made over $100,000 selling a digital product. In this video, I'm going to break down how I did it in 5 simple steps so that you can take these same steps and use it in your first or next digital product so that you can create some income for yourself and or your family if you have one and live the life of your dreams. Now, I want you to understand that results are not typical. It all depends on your work ethic and your mindset, and that's what I use in order to achieve the monetary goals that I have. I cannot guarantee that you're going to make the same income that I made, but I can guarantee you that if you stick to it and you don't give up and you put in the work, you will get some results. And depending on how fast you can learn and how skillful you can execute these steps, you could make a lot of money with digital products. And I stress this, if you watched that video, I told my story of how I lost everything during the pandemic. I ended up being homeless and I had to pull and scrape myself, my wife, and my 5 kids from out of poverty. We were living in our car. I had to figure out something very fast. And through my search, I stumbled on digital marketing and it changed me and my family's life. I went from being homeless to a homeowner to where I own my own house. It's completely paid for. Plus, I own properties that me and my family use as Airbnb to create multiple streams of income. I have cars that I also sell on Turo. I've been able to retire my wife. We no longer have to worry about money. My girls are ballet dancers, they're tap dancers, and they're into gymnastics. My son takes karate lessons, and my other son is into acting, and he takes drama classes. So this is what I want you to understand. If you stick to it, the money will come. And through my hard work, determination, and me never giving up, and also putting God first, I've been able to set my family up for financial success. So I'm going to try and break this all down step by step to let you know how I did it. And if you pay attention and you watch this video to the end, I'm going to show you how you can take advantage of my course to where you can get some more insight on how I did this so that you can get the proper learning and acquire the proper skills that you need in order to do this effectively. Let's get into it. Now, the first thing I had to do, I had to figure out who I was going to serve, who would be the best candidates and potential customers for my products. Do not go into this, especially if you're just starting out, trying to reach everybody. Pick one particular person, put that one person in your mind and decide how you're going to help them. Whoever you pick, you want to know these people or that person in and out. Okay. Now, for me, what I did, since I didn't know a lot about niches and niching down, I had an understanding of the concept that you do need to niche down. I just started with myself. I took myself back to where I was in the beginning, to where I was struggling, and figured out the path to get to where I was. And I basically just said to myself, what do I have now that I wish I had back then? What do I know now that I wish I had back then that would have got me here faster, minus all the mistakes? Another thing you can do if you're a little bit unsure, or let's just say you're just starting out yourself, one thing you can do is just have people tell you themselves what they're struggling with. What is your biggest challenge from getting you from where you are to where you're trying to go? All you have to do is put out content and then have those people fill out a Google form. And in your Google form, you can have 5 to 7 questions that they can answer. And then they're going to give you all the information you need. Once you know your audience and you know their problem, that's when you can start creating the product for them. And the cool thing about you doing this, you know that what you're creating is not a waste of time. If these people are having these problems, you know that they're going to buy it. Apparently, there's a gap in the market to where not many people are selling it, or the people who aren't explaining it in a way that helps these particular people. All right. So what you're creating is already a gold mine because you're getting a gold mine of information from these people. You just have to turn their problems into a solution in the form of a digital product. Once you have that information, you yourself have to know how you're going to help them get from point A to point B based off how you got there yourself. All you're doing is using using the same framework and helping them with what you learned how to do. You have to have some type of framework or system on how to help them. Okay, so you have to have achieved some type of thing. If not, you first have to figure it out and experiment with yourself. And then once you discover the solution, then you can start helping those people. All right. And it doesn't have to be something big. It doesn't even have to be something where you made a lot of money. It could be something as simple as how to get your logo for your business. These people don't know how to do this. How to get your LLC. Maybe you've come that far and done that. Or how to create your first landing page in order to sell your digital product. You need something that you have achieved, that you figured out the problem for, to help those people, and you have to understand that. Now, the next thing you're going to want to do after you have that is figure out the vehicle that you use that you're going to teach them how to use themselves in order to get on the roadmap to success. I knew I was going to help 9-to-5 workers, but more specifically, people who are trying to leave their 9-to-5, okay? And this could be dads and or moms. You can get as specifically as that. You could get divorced moms or single moms, or the same for dads. Any type of people, or maybe you're working currently yourself. Maybe you're a nurse. Maybe you're a trucker. Maybe like me, when I first started, I was really targeting retail store managers. I hated retail. I liked the pay and the bonuses, but it was so demanding of my life and my work-life balance. Okay, so I knew all the problems that general managers of retail stores face, to where I could put out content and say words and phrases that they understand and can resonate with. And I used that edge and advantage to connect with them on a deeper level. So that's what I want you to understand first when you niche down. And then your vehicle is digital products. Now, that is a broad vehicle. For example, there's digital marketing, and then there's digital products. That's a little bit niche down, but what I went into specifically was eBooks. So now I can say something like, I help retail store managers leave their job with digital products using eBooks. So now I'm talking to those people who are having that problem where they want to leave their job but don't know how. I'm telling them, here's a way that you can do it, because I did it myself with this type of way, which is digital products and eBooks. Okay, so you want to have your slogan, I help X achieve Y with or without doing Z or using Z. So that's the framework. Now that you have your audience, the second thing you want to do immediately after you have your audience, before you even create the product, before you start doing landing pages, before you start learning about marketing and doing a marketing strategy, the second thing immediately, once you have this information, you got that data, all right, you know how you're going to help these people, you even know who you're helping, the next thing you want to do immediately before you start all the crazy hard stuff is putting out content. Okay, immediately go on TikTok, go on Facebook, go on YouTube, whatever platform that you choose, and put out content and start telling people about who you are, telling your story, telling them how you can help them based off your experiences, right? You want to put out content that's going to bring awareness that you exist in the world, all right? And building the connection and growing your following. You want to start building the customer and the connection now before you have the product, okay? This process alone takes some time. Don't wait till you've already have it done. You have everything built, all the automations and everything you're going to need. And then you start marketing and promoting. That's a process by itself. If you do this right, by the time you finish with your product and the website and the funnels and your domain and all that stuff, you can already have customers ready to buy. And this is how we get those crazy results in a short amount of time. So when you see a video or you see someone posting something like, hey, I made X amount of dollars in this crazy, insane short amount of time, they're not telling you that, hey, before this even happened, for 3 or 4 or 6 months, I did all of this. And while I was doing this, when I dropped this product, this is how I was able to sell it so fast. because everybody was waiting for it. Okay. So immediately after you have that information, you start, even when you don't have all the answers and all the dots aren't connected, put out the content. Okay. So you're going to put out content just talking about yourself and telling everybody your experiences of how you got to where you are. Think of social media as you just trying to make friends. Okay. You trying to make a connection. And the main thing is you're just letting people know that you exist. All right. And you can build the anticipation of, hey, I have something coming that's going to help you guys. It's going to remove all the mistakes that I had to go through when I first started on my journey. So just a quick recap. Step one, choose your niche, narrow it down to the T. Who are you talking to? Step two, get data and information from those people. Make sure you know what their problems are. Step three, put out content immediately. So now we're up to step four. Step four is now we're going to actually start creating our ebook. All right. So we're selling an ebook. That's our vehicle. All right. In our ebook, what we're going to do is start telling them how to do X, Y, Z. Okay. You're going to break that down in your ebook. Now, there's a lot of ways to create your ebook. I'm not going to tell you in this video. I'm just giving you the step-by-step framework that I use. Okay. But I suggest that you sell an ebook. An ebook can be a low and mid-cost product that people are comfortable buying. You'd be surprised how much $29, $47, $37 adds up. Real quickly, because people can comfortably pay that amount versus something that sells for $497 or $997 or any other price four figures and above. All right, so that's a comfortable price to start selling a digital product. But before you start selling that digital product, you want to make sure you're collecting their email addresses with a freebie. So you're going to learn that when you're getting all that data from all the people that you interview or the people that you were asking, or maybe you went on ChatGPT and just asked it, what's the biggest problems that these people are having? And you're even going to discover why you're putting out the content in your comments. People are going to be asking you some questions, and there's going to be some repetitive things that they're asking you over and over. So now you can create a freebie, which is a free download that you can give them in exchange for their email address. All right. So while you're putting out that content, getting ready for your ebook, you should already have a freebie or start preparing your freebie alongside your ebook. Okay. And that freebie only solves one problem, that immediate problem that they're having. Okay. We're not trying to give away all the sauce. That's what the ebook is for. Maybe they don't know how to put out content. All right. They're asking you, how do you sell your ebook? What content do I put out? All right. First, in the beginning, you'll say, here are my top performing content, blah, 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 checklist that you can put out to attract buyers, whatever that thing is. And that freebie is just giving broad information. We're answering their questions in the freebie, okay? And it's got to be a real good freebie. I don't want you to think that because you're giving it away for free that it's trash and it doesn't really help them. You actually want to help them in the freebie. But what I do want you to understand is don't overdo it. Make it quick and simple, okay? We're just solving this one particular problem. Everything else they want to know and all the next steps and all the new problems that are even created, once a person solves that problem, is for your actual product, and that's what they're paying for. They see the value in your ebook. Now, in your freebie, okay, you have to be thorough. You have to give some value because it's going to set the tone of whether or not they want to purchase anything for you when your ebook is ready. But if your freebie is trash, you're increasing the potential of them saying, yo, this freebie didn't help me with anything. Why should I buy their ebook? You don't want them to think or feel that way. You want them to say, yo, he's giving me all this information for free. If I buy this product, he's going to blow my mind. All right. So you have to give away a very good freebie. So we're going to recap again because I know I'm moving fast. Choose your niche. Narrow down your audience. Step two, interview them. Find out what problem they're having. Step three, Once you have that information, put out content. Step four, create your freebie so that you can give away in exchange for your email addresses as you grow on social media while you're putting out that content. And then step 4.5, also be creating your ebook. All right. Now, step 5 is the most important thing. The thing that made me make all the money, I automated it all. After the ebook was done, because you'll learn even when you're putting out content, even when your ebook is done, there's going to be some other things that may not be in the ebook. So I was able to create some side products that I can use as upsells. Okay, so the person can purchase this with the ebook. Or if they didn't purchase the upsell, there was a downsell for selling a lower price item that could help them if they can't afford the upsell. There's also something called order bumps that I also did in the automations. And all this happens when they go to the landing page. So now that we have our freebie, now that we have our ebook, now that we have some order bumps, upsells and downsells, that increases the cart value of the customer. Okay, so they came here to purchase something $29, but they ended up spending $67 or $77 because they got the side products. And this is how I turned a $29 ebook into hundreds of thousands of dollars. Now, here's the sauce. In the ebook, when they're reading, I'm promoting the other things as well. There are also affiliate links to other tools or softwares that I use in order to become successful with digital products. So I'm earning commissions on the back end of those things. Your ebook can spawn one customer into a repeat customer or make it feel like they're multiple customers. Don't leave money on the table when you're creating your ebook. Add affiliate links. Add your other call to actions to your other products and or services. And while they're learning, you're just telling them the pathway to get to where they are, to where you are, and you're giving call to actions to other products, tools, software, and services that help you. And it increases your sales through the ebook. Then secondly, your funnel. When they go to your funnel, they're being sold additional items. The best way to get people to buy other products is while they're buying a product right now. It's impulse buying. All right. Let's just say those people only get your freebie. This is how you really make money. With your email list. Your email list is directly talking to them. And if your email list is being emailed every single day, you're connecting with them, you're talking with them, you're even giving value in your emails, and then you have emails that are telling them about products they are going to buy. Some people may not be able to buy right then. It has nothing to do with your content, nothing to do with the products, nothing to do with anything negative that you might be thinking that you're doing wrong. They just haven't gotten paid yet. It could be as simple as that. Your email is reminding them and redirecting them to your other products and offers. I make so much money just off my email. And guys, you have to understand, you need to put as much knowledge, skill set, time, and devotion to building that email list and building an email list of buyers. I have an ebook, you guys, that I created, and it's called How I Made Over $27,000 Selling a $29 ebook. And I break down everything that I just explained to you inside the ebook. Most people have been telling me I should sell this ebook alone for hundreds of dollars. I'm going to give it to you for a one-time price of only $17. And it comes with bonuses and videos and video tutorials. And when you purchase it, it comes with master resale rights and you can sell it and keep 100% of the profits, you guys. I don't know anybody on the internet who's doing anything like that. If you want to get access to this ebook, it's going to be down in the YouTube description. I want you to take charge of your life. I want you to understand that you can do anything that you put your mind to. I'm blown away every time I get a ping from somebody who just purchased any of my digital products. I get paid while I'm in the shower. I get paid while I'm sleeping. I get paid when I'm going to church. I get paid when I'm taking my kids to their events. I get paid 24/7 throughout the day and week. That is financial freedom. I have total control over my life. I'm my own boss, and you can achieve that. All right. And I break it down in this ebook. If you would like that, it's going to be in the YouTube description. All right. So get that ebook. I know it's going to help you out a great deal. But after you learn all the information in that ebook, what's the next steps? Well, that's going to be on this next video right here. Because when you pair what you just learned in this video with what you're going to learn in the next, then it's going to make you way more powerful. So stay blessed, and I'll see you on the other side of success. And or the next video, whichever comes first. I'm out.